Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And recently, Databricks has been coming up, but more specifically, it's been coming up in regards to Microsoft Fabric. And people are like, hey, Patrick, I'm used to working in this Azure Databricks environment, and I like to keep, you know, write my notebooks there. Can I read and write data from Databricks to Microsoft Fabric? I'm like, yeah, you can. You need to, wait. Enough of all this talking. You know what we like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. The first thing you want to do is you'll set up a Databricks workspace, and you need to enable premium in that workspace, because what you want to do is on your compute, go to advanced, and there's an option you need to enable called credential pass-through for user level data access. And this would allow Databricks to easily communicate with your OneLake in Fabric. It can read the data, it can write the data, so it'll just pass through your authentication. Now, you can possibly use a service principle. The documentation says that. I'll get a link to that documentation and post it in the description below. So once you get all this set up, I have a notebook over here that I started working on. And what you need to do is head over to Fabric. And so you can see I don't have any tables in my lake house. I do have a folder with some files. And so you need to get that Azure Blob file system path for these files so you can access these files. So you can click on any level. I'm gonna go here at the top level and go to properties because I'm gonna do something a little different. So I'm gonna copy this. You can see this is the ABFS path. Then I'm gonna head back over to Databricks. And I'm gonna type Fabric, no caps. I ain't yelling at no one. There we go. Equals, like that. And we're gonna get rid of the files part. And then what we're gonna do is, I'm gonna copy and paste because I don't want to bore you. It's just some simple, very simple Python here. So what I'm doing is I'm going to read the CSV files into a data frame. And I just wanna show you, I can do some light transformations. I'm just converting these strings to some dates. And then I'm gonna display 10 of those rows. So let's go ahead and run this. Let's see, all right? It's running the command. Boom, you can see there's my dates. And then here's all my data. This is pretty cool. I can read the data from the Fabric OneLake using Azure Databricks. It's easy, I didn't do much. I configured my compute, toggled that little box for the pass-through, then I wrote some Python code, not bad. But what about writing? Can we write out to the Fabric OneLake or to Fabric Lakehouse? So let's go back over to the Lakehouse really quick. And you can see right now, I'm gonna refresh this just to prove to you, there's no tables. There's no tables here. So I'm gonna go back over to Databricks. I have another little Python script that I wrote. I'm gonna go ahead and paste this in here. You can see I'm using the same path, that same Fabric OneLake path. I'm using that. It's just I'm going to a different place this time. I'm going in the table section. So I've already populated that data frame with all the data from those CSV files. Now I'm gonna write it out as Delta to my Lakehouse in Fabric. So we're gonna go ahead and run this. It's running my command. Here's the Spark job. Done, that was pretty fast. Let's head back over to Fabric. We're gonna refresh that table section. Boom, there's my daily sales. Now, I have a notebook here where I wrote a little SQL, so let's just verify. So we're gonna run this query. Let's see what data I get out. Boom, you can see for each one of those days, this is each one of those files, here's a corresponding count for the number of sales. All right, I can read some data from Microsoft Fabric and Azure Databricks, and I can write to Microsoft Fabric Lakehouse with Azure Databricks. Now, just a little asterisk here, when you use Azure Databricks as your compute and it creates those tables, that table is not vOrder enabled. So you may not get the same level of performance as if, let's say, data flows or a pipeline, or you use a notebook in Fabric to write those tables out to your Lakehouse, because they are by default vOrder able. So you'll need to come back and enable vOrder and do some optimization on those Delta files to get that same level of performance. All right, what do you think? If you tried this, I'd love to know. If you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Fabric, take a look at the playlist that's flying over my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.